Hello, my name is Mohab Sabir. I am the executive director of Al-Madina for Performing and Digital Arts. Al-Madina founded at 2000 and it's founded as an independent theatrical group, and we transformed to work in culture management and culture projects at 2007. Now our main project is Studio Medina, which is the place we are sitting in it now. It's a space for free expression for artists and youth initiatives. We have another main project is called Training in the Street. It's a project from 2011 until now. It's work by training artists out of closed venues. It's project searching for freedom of expression. The methodology of the project is to bring artists and to go to marginalized neighborhoods and streets and make the training of the workshop in the open spaces, public spaces, with partnership of trainers from Europe and Egypt. We made 12 training workshops in Alexandria in dancing, clowning, storytelling, multimedia, music, theater of the oppressed. The idea is coming from to make people at public spaces to have their own voice, because artists have a prejudging and stereotypes about street and how people think about in the street. So the idea is to combine artists and people, inhabitants in public neighborhood, to create the idea of the artistic performance together and to have their voices heard. We use this methodology when we are making a training in the street, because our idea is to bring a trainer from Europe and the Mediterranean and another trainer to be from Egypt, because both of them exchanging experience, the Arabic one, Egyptian one, give him the idea how to work in Egypt, how to understand people, and how he can make flexible training. And also the Egyptian trainer can gain experience on the artistic methodology. So both of them to provide the training for the participants. I think for Al-Madina, we are funded by European institutions, international institutions, by call for proposals, and with partnership and networking with NGOs in Mediterranean and Europe, and also in the Arab world. I think the policies of the European Commission and the international foundations have to be from real experiences. So not to, even in any report, they have a question, what is you recommend for us? So everyone make recommendations, but they didn't apply these recommendations. So you know the experience and you have recommendation upon experiences. So why you don't change the policies to fit the reality? We want to make, we have a very challenging topics in streets and human rights and democracy and women. So why we have another challenging in writing proposals and in financial management? So you are challenging in every way. I think the culture management and art management in Alexandria and Egypt is different from another countries or another models, because in Egypt we don't have the infrastructure of the culture management. So we are have the idea of culture management and art management and this science, but we apply it with another flexibility to fill the gap of needs in Egypt. When we work in streets, we work in coffee shop, so we have to pay drinks for the cleaners and the participants. So we have to get back a receipt. So how you can get a receipt? Registered or approved receipt from a local coffee shop in poor neighborhood. So we have to find solutions how to be flexible and to understand the reality of each project and each place you are working on it. We have to change policies which to be fit with the reality of the art and culture and development also, to make sustainable development, because art and culture now I think it's one from the main creative ideas who can make a sustainable and creative economy. So I think now we are going to work through arts and crafts and recycling and handmade, which is can make the idea of creative economy and entrepreneurship. So to create initiatives who can empower socially and economic empowerment for women and for youth, who can make a sustainable development at the society and local communities. Conferences pay a lot of money in five-star hotels and in dinners, and so for what? For talking and for leaders talking, not for exchanging experience. I think those leaders have the experience to go in many countries and to know and to work. And but I think the community leaders, not governmental leaders, the community who is work with people and work and sitting with people in the street, not in closed offices and work with diplomatic issues, you know. We have to work on social transformation and democratic transformation, so we need to be near and work in the street and with people to provide topics and open discussion about very essential topics now, not for spending money for leaders to talk. We want to spend money to learn people.